Good evening and welcome out, everybody. This is Coach Frank with Tackle Trading here tonight to take you through the Tackle Trading website, show you around a little bit, answer any questions that you may have, hopefully give you a couple pointers, and have a little bit of fun along the way. We'll give folks just one more minute here and then we will get officially rocking and rolling. See if I can get my YouTube chat wants to work with me. We'll see about that, right? The beauty of live content. So, and me especially. So give it just one more moment there. It looks like maybe I've just got a little YouTube delay, which tends to happen sometimes. So give it just one more minute. I will break down the site. When I'm explaining tackle trading, I kind of break it into thirds. I call it, things that you can do on your own. That's going to be things like, courses and blogs and tools and fun stuff like that. Then things you can do with others, that's going to be our live content that we're doing, once a week or every market day, depending on what exactly it might be. And then our weekend reports that we can share trade ideas, our stance on the market with our team each and every week as well. So that'll be kind of the angle that we come at it here this evening. So we'll just kind of take it from the top, I suppose, and go with the things that you can do on your own. But before I do any of that, welcome out to Tackle Trading. It's great having you with us. Always room in my life for one more trader. That is for darn sure. And I'm excited to have an opportunity to hang out a little bit with you tonight. Let's talk courses. We have several courses available to all of our pro members, and we also have a handful of premium systems as well. That's these premium systems that you see down here. The Tackle 25 is a covered call-based system on a select group of stocks that we put together each year, particularly with the idea of selling covered calls on for the upcoming year. Our STEP system is our swing trading system, standing for stop loss, target entry, and position size. Our cash flow condors is another cash flow system on the Russell 2000 index, and the bear market survival guide is kind of what you probably would guess, protecting ourselves in bearish market conditions, particularly our long-term trading account. And hey, CR, no, they're going to be coming through YouTube, although I'm still waiting on my YouTube feed to give me the live stream. For some reason on my other device, it's not doing it, but I am live. I know it says I'm live. So I'll come back and do a quick peek at these though, CR, if I do miss any tonight. So I'll make sure to do that for sure. Welcome out, my man. Good to see you. So we do have our handful of premium systems. What these are kind of a one-time purchase. The system is yours for life, all of the coursework, the list of companies and things like that. And then once a month, we get together with the team, in a mastermind group. We'll talk a little bit more about that here in the very, very near future. If you want a little more information on any of those systems, they will be the only thing that aren't available to you as a pro member. Don't hesitate, send us an email to team@tackletrading.com. Hit us up in one of our shows, head over to the store and get a little more information, hop into the clubhouse, ask any folks who are using those systems what they think. Don't hesitate to reach out if you have any questions in regard to any of those premium systems. Kind of coming back to our pro membership though, because that's really what we're focused on here tonight. We've got several courses. Our 7-step guide to trading is, it's one of those courses that if you're a brand new trader is really helpful to kind of start to put some of the pieces together, right? There's a trading's big, right? And we do kind of need to organize it a little bit. If you're new, this can really help. If you're an experienced trader, you probably have a lot of, systems and routines in place already. Still be helpful, probably get a couple of ideas, maybe make your life a little bit easier. So I think this can be useful, really wherever you might find yourself when it comes to trading and how much experience you have. It'll also kind of give you an idea of kind of the tackle trading way. I mean, there's a lot of us here at Tackle Trading, and I don't know that any two people trade exactly the same, but I think at the foundational level, we all kind of take that same approach from starting at the top of the market in our evaluation, our analysis of things, choosing our strategies, finding our trades, prepping them, placing them, managing them, journaling them. I think we all we might have different ways that we do that, right? And different, you know, different approaches. But I think at the foundational level, you'll find that all of us here at Tactical Trading kind of come at the markets from that point of view. A short course, I would definitely encourage everyone to take a little bit of time to work through it. And there you are, CR, I see you on YouTube. Good to see you. So of course we're traders, and as traders, charting technical analysis is critical for us, right? That's, you know, the really the basis for when we're doing things, how we're managing them, all of that fun stuff. So you'll find a technical analysis 101 course in here to help you get a better understanding of those charts. What I love about technical analysis is it takes me and my biases out of it. It's applicable to all instruments, all time frame. So whether, you know, you're a day trader trading, you know, really, you know, short term in the currency market, trading cryptos, doing traditional stock swing trades, cash flow trades, whatever it is, you are going to be using technical analysis. And I believe the better that you are at technical analysis, no matter what else you like to do, what kind of trading you prefer, you're going to benefit from that. Definitely worth taking a look over there. You will also find over in the shows tab, the Tackle 100 series live webinars. And there will be multiple recorded webinars in here, in particular, the Technical Analysis 101 course that Coach Noah Davidson taught live for us a little while back, where he's still, you know, he's teaching the same concepts that you'll go over in Tech 101, just to coming at a little bit different angle, you know, a little bit more of a webinar format as opposed to a course format. It's a lot like learning a language, I think, when it comes to charting it. The more you see it, hear it, and speak it, the faster you're going to pick it up. This is a two-parter. Each of these is about 2 hours long, so you're looking at about 4 hours in, or thereabouts for both of those webinars. Definitely worth checking out. While we're in here, there's a great swing trading webinar that Coach Matt did for us, kind of building off of the things that you'll talk about in technical analysis, setting up targets, setting up stop losses and entry points from a swing trading point of view. Maddie did an awesome job on that one. Coach Grant has a futures webinar in here if you've always wanted to learn a little bit more about the futures market without going too crazy. It's a great place to start. He, you know, does a really nice job kind of, you know, humanizing it, I guess, a little bit for that. Let's see. After completing futures for trading options on the most, what I would probably do, and I'll come back to that question because it'll probably depend on you. But if you're looking for options on futures, last March, and maybe I'll just bring it up right now so I don't try to forget it. Last March, we did a 4-week series on trading futures. One of those will be on trading options on futures as well. It'll be last March that you'll see that. You'll find them in the archives, in the Coach's Show archives, I should say. So they were last March. It'll be a few pages back in the archives, but that might be a really good place to start if you're looking for futures on options themselves. So I'm not sure if that answered that, but I hope that it gave you a little bit of insight towards that. You'll also find several step system webinars. As I mentioned earlier, that's our swing trading system, just stop loss, target entry, position size. If you need a little bit of help in building some rules and getting started, this can be a great place to start, get a little bit, you know, to know that step system a little bit more, kind of see what it's all about. All of the things that, you know, we trade here at Tackle Trading and talk about, all the ways we talk about trading, really, or at least from swing trading point of view, comes from the step system itself. So this can be really helpful. One of the, you know, odd things about, you know, being a new trader, or, you know, a relatively new trader, is you don't necessarily have rules. You know you need them, but you don't know what they should be, so you have a hard time developing them. This can maybe give you some ideas if you're struggling from that point of view to kind of get the ball rolling on that side of things. Of course, we've got a course on options. Options 101 is really going to focus on options, the contract itself. What happens when you buy or sell that call or put option? What are the factors that are influencing the price of that contract, right? There's a lot of, you know, different little things when it comes to options. And the more we understand the contract itself, I think the better understanding we're going to have on the option strategies, which I'll show you where you can find them here in the very near future. If you, you know, have that interest in taking a closer look at either the futures and or the currency market, the Futures 101, Forex 101 course, a great place to start. And for a lot of people, and it was this way for me, I always felt like futures was just too crazy for me to even think about looking at, you know, when I was newer to trading. And really, it just was a little bit of a different market. And there was definitely some things you need to understand about it. But, you know, if I can trade a stock, I can trade a futures contract. So I just need to understand kind of what's going on in that market. And the same can be said when it comes to currency. So if you always, you know, I don't really care. There's a lot of things to trade. And, you know, if you trade what you like, right? And I think that's a good thing. I always want people to feel like, yeah, I looked into it, it just wasn't for me. Or I looked into it and I really liked it. I always want to feel like we're coming at it from a place of strength as opposed to, that's too big for me or whatever. So both of those courses, very nice. If you're looking to get a little more intel on either the currency or the futures market, definitely a great place to start. No matter what you do, systems development is going to be very important. We're traders. We need to treat our trading like a business. And we all get that, but it's our money. If we're not careful, it's really easy to treat it like a casino. We don't want to do that, right? Everybody knows it's important to have rules and systems and plans. We all agree with that. I've talked to thousands of traders in my life, and every one of them said, yeah, it's a good idea to have some rules, but again, that might not be our default setting. The system development course is really designed to help you think about trading from a systems builder perspective. It is an awesome course. I cannot recommend it enough. No matter what kind of trading you like to do, I would make some time in the, you know, not too distant future to take a stab at that system development 101 course. Of course, over in the Trade Center is where you'll find our playbook. So whereas the options course itself is going to really be focusing on the contract and not exclusively or in depth on different strategies, our playbook is where you will find all of those. We break our strategies into three core areas, Delta, Theta, and Vega. If you're an option trader, that probably makes sense immediately. If you're not, that's okay. I'll try to explain it really quick. Delta is directional trading. I think the stock's going to go up. I want to profit. What can I do? Well, I could buy some stock. I could buy a call option. I could do a call ratio. I could do a bull call. I could do a bull diagonal. There's different ways that I could trade directional. But at the end of the day, I think the stock's going to go up or down, right? That we'll do the bearish counterparts. So when you hear delta, think direction or movement, right? Kind of what most of us think about when we think about trading. Oh, I think this is going from point A to point B. Right. Cool thing about options is we get to sell them. So that's going to be our theta or our cash flow side of things. That's where I'm the one selling you, you know, that call option that you're buying for whatever my reasons might be. And I'm bringing in that premium. That's going to be things like covered calls. Hey, I own 100 shares of company ABC. I'll write a call against it, bring in a little bit of cash flow, things like naked puts. You know, I don't own, you know, any XYZ, but if it ever dropped to $40, I'm in, I can write a naked put, make that commitment and cash flow along the way until I get those shares. That's going to be things like our credit spreads, where, you know, we want to build a trade that says this is going to stay above or below a particular price over the next little while, the marry the two together and do an iron condor. So theta, cash flow, right? And those are the two big ones. And then I always call Vega the little brother of option trading. That's going to be volatility, right? We're just thankfully coming out of earnings season. Finally, we still have a bunch, but most of them are behind us. There's no way for me to know if a company, you know, what it's going to do on earnings, right? No matter how much I try to convince myself, but I might, you know, be able to, based on the stock's history, I might feel like there's an edge, thinking, you know what, it's going to move more than the market expects, or maybe the market expects a lot bigger movement than I do. It's a way for me to trade into that volatility. So these will be more bi-directional trades where I'm not picking a side. I'm basically saying the market's going to move more or less than expected. So that's going to be Vega or volatility when it comes to that. In all of these, we'll have a detailed video going over the strategy, what our rules for the strategy are, why we would choose that strategy. We'll put in an example using the Thinkorswim platform or TOS platform, kind of taking your beginning to end. There's also a little cheat sheet, PDF, so you can have easy access to those rules for those strategies without always having to revisit the video, especially when you're learning them. You'll notice that all of them have, you know, plus one to plus two, minus one or minus three to minus two to minus three. so on and so forth. And we always want to match the strategy to our view of the situation. So if you kind of think about it, zero is flat neutral. One would be bullish, or minus one would be moderately bearish. Two or minus two would be, you know, I would just say bullish or bearish. And then three would be very bearish or bullish. That's kind of at least the way that I like to think about them. So you can kind of see where we have these strategies ranked as far as, you know, if I want to aggressively trade something versus more conservatively trade something. If I think a stock's going to move quick, I'm probably going to look to a different strategy than if I think it's going to be a slow grind, but it's going to get there, right? So I might be wrong, right? I'm not always right, but I do want to match the strategy to my read of the situation. So that's what you'll find, this minus one, minus two, and things like that. So you can spend a lot of time in this playbook. If you're brand new to options, great place to start is just practicing with calls and puts. It's just one leg, right? No other moving parts. Helps you get to know the contract a little bit. Everything will spring off of that if you need a place to start, if you're just learning those options right now. Beyond the playbook and the different courses, we do a lot of blog content every week. We're going to have some blog content, just another fast, easy way to share ideas with our team, whether it's more charting and tales as a technician, more options and option theory, hearing from our awesome female trading community over in Women in Trading, taking concepts from the ground up and building with Coach Greg over in the Rookie Corner. These are going to be fast reads, right? You know, 5 minute, 6 minute type reads, but just another way that we can kind of share ideas with our team members. Over in the Trade Center itself, in addition to the playbook, where of course we just took a nice peek at that. In addition to that, you'll find a link to our trading journals, our trading glossary, and our events calendar. If you come directly into the Trade Center, it'll bring you kind of to a what's up at Tackle Trading page. What's our next show? What are our most recent posts, our most recent report? A little watch list if you want to build a watch list directly on Tackle Trading using these trading view charts. If you want to do that, you would just add Disney, just type your ticker symbol, get it in there, and then we'll just left click it. It'll highlight it blue. We'll hit the little plus button and that'll add it. If I decide I'm done with you, Autodesk, we're done. I want you removed. I'm just going to, you know, select them in the watch list, left click, get it highlighted and hit that minus button. This will save. So when I come back, these guys will still be in here. If you want to do that, it's pretty helpful. If you're doing your, you know, charting everywhere else, that's you know, somewhere else, that's perfectly fine too. There will be a replay or one of our live YouTube shows. Right now there's us, right? So it always weirds me out because I've got another device so I can watch the chat, and then I'm doing this, and then I see this on this. It's an odd feeling when I see it, but we'll have either a replay of our halftime report. Typically it's going to be our halftime report, or if our show's live, or it will be in here as well. A little mini upcoming event calendar, so you can kind of see, you know, what's going on in the days to come, where you are on any different courses that you might be taking on this will be in here as well. So if you know, on module 2, 6 minutes in on Futures 101, you can pick right back up where you left off here when you start back up. So it'll kind of keep you organized as well. I'm going to come back to your question here in a little bit, CR. We'll look together and see, right? We're not huge VIX people, but we brought it up a little bit. So I'll show you an easy way, hopefully, to be able to find stuff that you're looking for on Tackle Trading as well. But no courses themselves, but definitely will be some discussions on lots of different stuff. And I'll, you know, like I said, I'll try to show you an easy way to find some stuff. The search function is pretty smart here at Tackle Trading. You'll find a link to the Market Skyline, which will just take you kind of to a one-stop shop. Going to have the different indexes for the futures contracts, the major commodities, the sector spider ETFs, so you can quickly and easily, hey, what happened today, right? Really mixed day in the market, depending on what area of the market you look. You looked over at technology, discretionary, NASDAQ-type stocks, it was pretty rough. If you look at energy stocks, financial stocks, particularly energy, but finance had a pretty good day. So, you know, that's important information to know, right? So we can kind of see, you know, where things at, any particular area standing out technically for, you know, for potential, you know, movement. So just kind of the bigs. There's also a heat map. This will take you to finviz.com, where you can take a look at the, you know, the heat map for the S&P 500 for the day. If you want to get that visual Yeah, let's just go do it. It is free, so you will have to do some ads unless you're a subscriber of FinViz. But quick visual, so we can kind of see, hey, what did the day look like, right? It was really, kind of a mixed bag day, right? Some really, stocks, and particularly in tech, really, really struggled. Stocks, particularly in energy, really, really strong. So it gives us that nice visual of kind of what the day looked like. Get rid of that now. There will be a news aggregator that'll go through some of these different financial sites like MarketWatch, CNBC, Wall Street Journal, and just kind of put all the headlines in one spot. So we can just kind of scroll through and see if anything actually stands out and you want to take a closer look. It's really helpful so you don't have to bounce around six different financial sites. You're welcome to do that if that's your thing, but it's nice to kind of have it aggregated and I can just kind of scroll and see if there's anything that I want to click on. A link to the economic calendar, a link to our market reports, which we'll talk a little bit about here in a couple. Another link to our trade journals will be in here. If you come in this way, it will bring you to the video for the journal, the tutorial, if you need some help on it. It is important to journal your trades. That will make and save you money. So, and if you're not doing that, I would definitely encourage you to start. If you come in this way, again, you can get into it if you just highlight over the Trade Center and you'll get the link right there. But if you're in the Trade Center itself, just scroll down and your download will be in here. There will be, of course, the Trade Journal, which is what we're looking at right here. There's also the Theta Research Journal for our cash flow trades, and the Portfolio Journal to help you keep organized with your account as well in here. So you just click on the one you wanted and then just scroll down and you'll get the download right there. There's a link to our search function, another link to our glossary, a link to a chart if you ever need one, link to a compounding gains calculator. So just some different trader tools, built in here into the Trade Center to hopefully save you some clicks and bouncing around as you're going through your personal daily routines. Our Clubhouse is it's kind of like our own social media is how I would maybe explain it, where we can, you can ask questions, bounce ideas around with other members of the team. You're always invited to join us over there. We are active on all of the, more traditional social media platforms, obviously, YouTube. We do our, Monday night webinar, walking people through the site. We do our halftime report every market afternoon at 12:30 Eastern, where we go through the market with our team. We've got a lot of other YouTube videos as well, a lot of tutorials, a lot of walkthroughs, entire playlist on Thinkorswim tutorials if you need some help on that. So a lot of fun stuff going on YouTube. Facebook, if that's your thing, we do have a Facebook group. We certainly invite you to join us. If you're a Twitter user like me, another great place to be able to connect and share ideas with members of the team. So a lot of ways to, hang out, if you will. Over here at Tackle Trading. You'll also find a link to the Huddle. And of course, the Huddle each morning will be the top five stories of the day. Just a quick, efficient way for you to kind of get the big news of the trading day in a very short period of time. Pretty new and pretty exciting for sure. So definitely worth checking out. You'll also find the Trading Justice podcast. For some reason, my computer doesn't want to show it. It's right here. Usually, I don't know where it is today. It's there. It's just not there. See, I can see it. Meet our partner, Trading Justice. For some reason, the picture isn't coming up. But I think that's a me thing. Every week, Matt, Tim, and Mark do the Trading Justice podcast. You can find that on all of the major podcast providers. You can also listen to it directly on tradingjustice.com. There's also a fantastic monthly newsletter over at tradingjustice.com as well. So definitely would encourage you to head over, see what's going on over there. That the Trading Justice podcast, always a lot of fun, a lot of good banter, a lot of good information, and very much worth incorporating into your routine. From a week-to-week perspective. We'll kind of shift gears now into more, hey, what does the schedule look like, right? What are we doing? When are we doing it? As I mentioned earlier, every market day at 12:30 Eastern right here on our YouTube channel, we do our halftime report, live looking at the market where we go through that daily routine, talk stocks in the news. Where are we at technically? What's moving the market? How are these different areas of the market doing? Just to really go through that daily routine. I always, say the market's like a soap opera, or I always say professional wrestling for myself because I'm a professional wrestling fan. I've been watching it since the 80s, but I know most people, a lot of people don't do that. But if you follow the story, then you're always kind of on top of things, right? And that's kind of what we're doing over there. Interesting. So it's not just a me thing. Well, I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, SCR. So it makes me feel a little bit better. It's really about, going through over and over. Energy had a great day today, but energy's been strong lately, right? And that story has been building up over the last couple of months. And so we just want to follow along. And that's what we're doing in our halftime report. Over here at Tackle Trading, every market morning at 11 Eastern, we get together in our traders lounge where we get together with our team and answer any questions that you may be having. Maybe you're struggling with a particular strategy. Maybe you've got a trade setup you want to walk through. Maybe you are struggling with stop losses or routine. I mean, there's a lot of stuff to talk about in trading, right? We all have questions sometimes. And it's important to have a place to go where you can have those discussions. That's exactly what we're doing in our lounge every market morning, 11 a.m. Eastern. We're hanging out for an hour. You're always welcome. You're always invited, whether it's to ask questions or just come in and listen. Either way, and always know that you're more than welcome in there. We don't typically record that show because we just do so many of them, but we will record snippets, if you will. You'll find, of course, the information to get into the lounge, as well as those snippets in here. So, naked, return on naked puts, a couple days ago, market timing, management tips. So always going to, it's not a huge deal to clip a little snippet and throw it in here. If your schedule is such that you can never join the lounge because you're at work or something, but you have a question, let us know. We'll do our best to accommodate you, get a snippet in here for you. Just let us know. We're here for you. We have no problem trying to accommodate our team as best as we possibly can. So those are going to be our everyday shows. If the market's open, you can expect the lounge at 11. Go for about an hour, take a little breather, and then head over to our YouTube channel for the halftime report at 12:30. We'll be here hanging out with you every market day. Then we have our evening shows. On Monday nights, I do this webinar here on YouTube where I walk people through the website. You're always welcome to join me again or catch the recording. On Tuesdays, we do what I would probably consider our flagship show. That's awesome, Frank. Yes, Chevron, nice day. Nice day in energy all the way around. And great name, Frank. So the Coaches Show really allows us, we're a couple of days into the market on Tuesday nights, 8:30 Eastern. We can kind of just do a quick roundup, hey, where, what's going on, what's changed, or what's standing out in the market. But what it really allows us to do is take a one of the many topics. There's so many things we can talk about in trading, right? From indicators like stochastic, moving average, ATR, RSI, to strategies, long calls, bull calls, call ratios, to portfolio design, to daily routine, to trade management. I mean, there's a lot of things that we can talk about. What the Coaches Show really allows us to do is take one of these concepts and have that in-depth discussion on that one thing. Always a lot of fun, definitely worth catching. We obviously love to have you live, but we understand that schedules are schedules. And if you can't catch it live, it will be recorded, it will be archived. You can watch this week's, last year's, whatever you need to do. So, interesting. Looks like there might be some weird stuff going on. Thank you, Osiris. I'll have to mention that. I'm never the guy to fix that stuff, but I appreciate that. I will let somebody more tech savvy than me know. Appreciate that. So that's our Coaches Show Tuesday nights, 8:30 p.m. Eastern. Then on Thursday nights at 8:30 p.m. Eastern, we do our cash flow club. That's going to be much more narrowly focused on the cash flow strategies like those credit spreads, naked puts, covered calls, iron condors, right? So it's going to be a little bit more focused, maybe, than say the world of topics that are available to us in the Coaches Show. It's going to narrow it down really just to those particular cash flow strategies, both building as well as managing those strategies. Again, live at 8:30, will be recorded, will be archived if you need to revisit or if that's just an inconvenient time for you. On Wednesdays at 7 over here on our YouTube channel, 7 Eastern, I should say, we get together for our Trade Masters webinars where a couple of the coaches will bring five different trade ideas, bounce them around. with each other, with Coach Mark, with members of the team, and then Coach Mark will declare a winner. So a lot of fun to be able to hang out with other traders and get some ideas. So hope to see you over there. We're doing that on Wednesday night. Most Wednesday nights here at Tackle Trading at 8:30, we get together with one of the members of our mastermind teams, the Tackle 25 step system. It typically tends to be what happens on most Wednesday nights over here at Tackle Trading. So that's kind of what the schedule is going to look like. An easy way to think about it, at least for me, is the lounge is about your questions, where we can focus specifically on what you and our team members need. The halftime report really is about the daily routine, staying on top of things. And then our evening shows are where we can really focus on the teaching side of things. Hey, let's show you how to do this. Let's walk through that type of stuff. That's kind of an easy way to keep it organized, in your mind, if you will. So that's kind of what the schedule looks like. On Fridays, you will find our Mind of a Trader. The easiest place to find this is over in the events calendar in the Trade Center. Could we have a couple different ones of those? On Fridays, about an hour before the market closes, 3 p.m. Eastern, Coach Mark does his at the closing bell, where he just gets together with the team for an hour. He does his commodity report live, where he's going over, commodities technically and fundamentally, and also just bounces ideas around with team members, hey, what's game plan going into early next week, all that fun stuff. So that's Fridays at 3 p.m. Eastern. Easiest way to get in there is just come into this event calendar, and then we just click on it. You get the information. It'll take you there. And that was true for any of our different shows that you're looking to join us in. He also does a weekend prep class on Sunday night, a little bit after the futures market opens up. Hey, did anything change? What are we looking at going into the very early part of the trading week? So both of those, I would love to have you over there. In Fridays at 3 is when he does his market bell, and then on Sunday nights, I guess I should say, yeah, last time it was Monday because we had the holiday week, right? So he does that on Sunday night. So we'll be here in a lot of different ways, hanging out with you, and hope to see you. I'm sure that I will. Before we talk a little bit more about our reports here, let's quickly just talk about our tackle today. That's, our daily email. You can find it, archived in here. If you would like the daily email sent, you can sign up for the Tackle Today email in here as well. Very quick and easy to do. It will get to you faster if you do it in, get it emailed than, when it gets archived in here. But whatever works for you is fine with me. So let's kind of shift gears now that we've talked about kind of what the schedule routine type of thing looks like. For the most part, we do, keep it pretty regimented. We don't deviate too much unless weird holidays or something, get in the way. And we've got a ways till that'll happen again. So on Fridays, as the market's winding down, we get together as a team of coaches in what we call our scouting report meeting. And in that meeting, we all talk about kind of how we're individually seeing the market and the different sectors, different commodities, different currency pairs, trade setups that we're eyeballing going into the upcoming week. And out of that scouting report meeting comes our Tackle newsletter, stock, options, commodity, and Forex reports. Our Tackle newsletter, let's start there. We take that top-down approach. If you've already had a chance to go through the 7-step guide to trading, or maybe if you just noticed when we were looking at it, the first stop is start at the top of the markets, right? That's kind of what we do and what we believe in here at Tackle Trading. And that's exactly what we're doing in the newsletter. Hey, what are the storylines that are moving the market? What are the news stories? What's the mood, right? What's going on in the market right now, right? What's the economic calendar looking like in the upcoming week? Anything that we might want to keep an eye out for? Of course, we'll have a video and all of this stuff going over it with you. Where's the S&P? Kind of how are we seeing it? Kind of watching that pullback right now. The ETFs for the different indexes, if you need them, are in here. Diamonds, DIA, tracks the Dow. QQQ tracks the NASDAQ. IWM tracks the RUD. And SPY tracks the S&P 500. Coach Gino's Arkham High Low Indicator is in here that looks at the Kernels of the Market. It looks at over 8,000 stocks to kind of see, you know, hey, how bullish or bearish really are we, right? So we have a better idea of what's going on the internals of the market versus, say, just the top of the market, right? The Apples and, Amazons and Microsofts and things like that. The seasonality chart will be in here from a historical perspective. What does the market tend to do this time of year? Obviously, we don't want to overvalue that, but it is, you know, helpful information to know what the market tends to do from a historical perspective at any, you know, throughout the course of the year. Same with the sectors. What sectors tend to, historically speaking, be the strongest this month? February, from a historical point of view, tends to be a materials and energy, things you get out of the ground type of month, right? We'll have to see. Again, we don't want to overvalue that, but it's important to note. It's also important to note that just because, you know, finance and utilities tend to, you know, be the, relatively speaking, you know, weakest sectors in the month of February from a historical perspective, doesn't mean they have to go down, right? They might be the top performers, but they still might come, you know, finance still might come in last and have a very positive month. So it is all relative from that point of view. You'll find our sector rankings, so you can kind of get an idea of how we're seeing these different sectors. Are we, you know, where are we at? Are we liking it more than last week or less than last week? Kind of like our option strategies where we did the 0 to 3 or minus 3. It'll read a little bit differently though, because it's going to be very, very rare that we put an entire index or an entire sector into plus or minus 3 territory. Whereas it might be very easy for me to put a stock, I'm really bullish on this stock, right? I'm never going to be, personally, I'm never going to put the S&P 500 at a plus or a minus 3. I will never do that. That's just not how I do things. And you know, overall, we're kind of the same way. It's going to be very rare that you see us rank an entire area, right or wrong, in the very extreme plus or minus 3. So if you kind of think about it like a, you know, football, as you can kind of see the football field here, we're going to be, you know, moving, hey, you know, 3 or 4 or 5 yards in football, you know, is not a bad thing, unless maybe it's 3rd and 7, right? Then it might be. So you can kind of see how we're moving and how we're viewing the sectors. I think it's probably fair to say that you're not always going to 100% agree with us, which I think is perfectly reasonable and perfectly fine. It's always just nice to be able to get a different perspective, right? It's one of those things that the way I kind of see it is, a lot of times somebody might be more bullish than me on something or more bearish than me on something, but usually one of the coaches isn't, yeah, this is really bearish, and I'm looking at it saying, no, it's really bullish, right? If that ever happens, something weird's going on. So it's more probably a matter of, yeah, I like energy a little bit more than UCR, and you say, yeah, okay, well, fair enough, but you're probably not bearish on it, right? I'm like, no, not right now. I don't think there's any great reason to be. So we'll be ranking the sectors each week so you can kind of get an idea for where we're at there. You'll find the sector spider ETFs in here as well. We looked at them briefly when we were looking at the market skyline over in the Trade Center. These are great tools. If you're not familiar with them, what they do is they go into the S&P 500 and pull out just the stocks in that sector. So, you know, we talked energy. XLE is the energy sector ETF. So it goes into the S&P 500, pulls out just the energy stocks, puts those stocks in a portfolio. And that's what we're looking at here. So we're looking at an isolated look at energy, right? Without getting drug around one way or the other with real estate and, you know, technology, right? So it really helps us take an isolated look at these different sectors. As ETFs, these are tradable. They're very liquid. They're optionable as well. Some people really like to trade them. Some people, I usually like to use them as a guide. Oh, I like energy. Let's go look at energy stocks. Oh, I like finance. Let's go look at my financial stocks. Doesn't mean I will never trade the ETF, but personally, I do, you know, kind of use it more of a springboard. Okay, this area has caught my attention. Let's go look for some stocks in this area. But if you want a little bit more natural diversity, certainly makes a lot of sense. These are weighted like the S&P 500 is, right? So the bigger name companies, so energy is Chevron and Exxon, are going to be more heavily weighted than, say, a Marathon, you know, Marathon or a Holly or something like that. If you want a little more information about, you know, who are in these ETFs and how they're weighted, probably the easiest thing to do is head over to sectorspdr.com. That's the website, the ETF provider's website, where you can take a closer look at who are in these ETFs and how are these ETFs weighted. The notorious one, you know, the biggest notorious one is, you know, XLC, the communication sector. That's got Disney, Netflix, Facebook, Twitter, Google, those type of things. It's very, very heavily weighted towards Google and Facebook because those companies are so big, and there's two different, you know, classes of shares for Google. So it's very weighted towards those two companies. It's very hard for it to deviate too much from them. So those are just things that are important to note, especially if you're trading these ETFs, right? So that's kind of an up to you thing, but I do think they have a place in your daily routine. For sure, there will be a little bit of write up and more information in here. There will be a pre-built scanner. Well, there'll be a friendly reminder to match the strategy to the situation, right? There will be a pre-built scanner as well. So if you say, "Well, I really like energy, but I don't know a ton of energy stocks off the top of my head," I can head over here. Again, this will take us to a pre-built FinViz scanner. These are what I call trader-friendly stocks, and all I mean by that is they have good liquidity, very easy to trade shares on. They are optionable. When it comes to options, you always need to go double-check, see how that option liquidity is, and if you're not comfortable doing that, you will talk about that in that options course. It's very important. You don't want to get stuck in an illiquid option, I assure you. It's no fun at all, but these are optionable, so there's more than a fair chance I'll be able to build an option trade if that's the route that I want to go, and if the options aren't liquid enough for me, not a problem. I can always trade some shares, especially nowadays here in the States, right? We get $0 commissions on so many of these brokers. I can easily buy shares at this point in time. Going to just let us kind of browse, right? See if anything kind of stands out to us, right? And you might like things a little different than I do, and that's okay. But it just allows us to very quickly run through and see, you know, is there anything here that's really standing out? If something does stand out and you want a little bit more information on it, say like SLB, just click on SLB here. It'll bring up a little bit of a bigger chart. I don't think you can make a trade off of these. I know I certainly can't, but I can take that closer look and say, you know what? Yeah, this is worth going in and actually looking at it, my own charting platform, see if I like it. And sometimes I click on it and it looked a lot better from afar. So that will happen too. Just go back to screener if you do that, and that'll take you right back into this pre-built scanner that you can kind of scrounge, kind of work your way through. So that will be for all of the sectors. If any one of those particular areas catches your attention, easy way to naturally branch into that. Beyond our newsletter, we'll have our stock, option, commodity, and Forex report, kind of all going to, you know, spoiler alert, all kind of be what they kind of sound like, right? Coach Mark does our commodity report, and he does that live. It'll be, of course, recorded and posted here in the commodity report, where he can talk about the fundamentals as well as the technicals, as well as how he's approaching these different things within the commodities market. Commodity market's a fun place. A lot of cool things to do, a lot of fun things, even if you're a cash flow trader, a lot of really cool things you can do with commodities when it comes to cash flow. Forex, Coach Cody typically does that one for us, where he can highlight what's going on in these, you know, in the major currency pairs, upcoming news. He does a lot of teaching in there as well. So it's a great place to learn a little bit about Forex without having to step too far out of your comfort zone necessarily. If it's just, you know, I think, yeah, I'll just listen to it. I honestly believe if you just spend 20 minutes a week, you know, watching the Forex report, 3-4 months from now, you're going to be absolutely shocked how much you know about Forex, even if you never do anything else with it. He does a great job explaining that world to our team members. Of course, I think, you know, for broadly speaking, we're kind of a, you know, equity and options type of a place. So while we, you know, we'll look to do, you know, option strategies on commodities, we will, you know, highlight some swing trade ideas in both, you know, the stock and the options report. The stock report is going to allow us, there's going to be a couple of things that's going to really differentiate the two. I mean, obviously, when we're looking at the names, we're looking at more likely a stock trade in the stock report, right? You know, no, that's nothing crazy there. There is going to be a little bit of, you know, bleed over, though. If you wanted to trade an option on something you found in the stock report, there's no shame in going and checking the liquidity on that option and see if it's something you'd be comfortable with, right? So sometimes it will and sometimes it won't be, but there's no shame. Just make sure you are checking that liquidity and make sure you're always doing that, right? but it really is going to allow us to focus exclusively on the technicals. You know, why is this here? You know, why is ADS here coming into this week? Why is Five here coming into this week? Why is Jets here coming into this week? Right. So we can kind of talk you through the trade itself, kind of what we're seeing from a, you know, pattern perspective, a potential entry perspective, targeting, you know, stop loss placement, all of that fun stuff. Everyone's going to do their, you know, use their own rules, right? You might be more, you know, aggressive with your stops than me, and that's fine. We want to just make sure you have some good actionable swing trade setups every week. If you need them, the video will really allow us to talk you through these technicals. We'll also do a little bit of teaching this week. You know, Coach Greg really did a lot on stop loss movement, right? The eternal question, right? How much do I move my stop loss? You know, I got stopped out today. You know, that stuff always happens. We have can have those types of discussions as well. We'll always, you know, try to have, you know, both a bullish and a bearish list. These days, the market's really, really bullish. There's not a lot of bears out there, right? You can't force the issue. But we always want to have some trade ideas on both sides. We'll do our best to find candidates, you know, even though you know, it's been a rough run for the bears lately, right? I don't know any bears really. So, but when the market, you know, eventually it probably will have some sort of a sell-off or correction, right? And I just want to have some watchlist candidates for when that time comes. I'm not expecting it to come tomorrow or anything like that, but I'll always be prepared. The options report's going to be built very much the same way, but we're going to talk a little bit more on the strategy selection side, right? Because, hey, this is a candidate to trade. We can trade it with stock, sure, but if it's an option candidate, should I look to create a delta or a theta strategy, right? Should I look to sell naked puts or buy calls, right? We can have those type of discussions in addition to the technicals side of things. So we'll kind of, you know, be coming at it the same way, same type of trade setups, right? Nothing wrong with trading a stock on something in the options report. That's not going to be an issue whatsoever. There are going to be plenty liquid for that. But it's really going to allow us to, you know, highlight not just the technicals, but the strategy selection side of things when it comes to the option world as well. So again, much like the, you know, the stock report, we'll use it as an opportunity to teach. So, you know, this week Ty was doing it on selling naked puts on CCL was his example. So can do a lot of teaching in there. We want to make sure that we, you know, share trade ideas with our team members. You don't have to like any of them. You can like all of them. You can pick your favorites, right? We just want to make sure you have some trade candidates every week, right, that are outside of your own personal watch list. All of these will be step system candidates through our swing trading system. So it can help you get to know that a little bit more as well. You can expect these by Saturday afternoon, so you have plenty of time to go through any or all of them before the markets open back up. Don't be afraid to prioritize, right? I always tell people, build your own tackle trading. If you're a brand new trader, you know, I talk to you, you're a brand new trader. We're going to have a little bit of a different discussion than if we talk and you've been trading options for 2 years, right? It's okay to build your own tackle trading, right? There's a lot of us, a lot of different levels, people that are brand new, people been doing this for a very long time and everything in between. It's okay to prioritize. It's okay to build your own tackle trading. So don't be afraid to do that. I'd always rather, you know, you do a great job with two than a so-so job with five. You know, what I would always suggest, start with a newsletter, because starting with that top-down approach is, it's just good practice, I think. It's just a good philosophy to take when it comes to trading. So that's going to be our weekend report. Again, you can expect those by Saturday afternoon, so you have plenty of time to get through all of them. As we get winding down here, if you have any questions, feel free to ask. See, I just kind of want to show you the search function here is pretty smart. So I'm just going to go in and search VIX. Whoops, I guess I put one too many V's. I'm not a VIX guy, but that's just me. There we go. So I'm just going to throw in VIX here. I'm going to come into view all results and we'll see what we can find. So you got, you know, tips for, you know, hey, when I, you know, VIX is high, what are some tips there? Tyler got some different blog stuff going on in here on the VIX. So there is going to be quite a bit, and you never know for sure, right? I can't promise you that whatever you're looking for is going to be in here, but there is a very good chance if you're looking for something this is a great place to start. You know, it's very fast, very easy to see if there's anything in there. If there's not, don't ever be afraid to bring up those discussions, CR, over in the lounge. Don't be afraid to bring those up for discussion. Not every coach is going to do it. If you want to talk VIX with me, I'm not going to be that useful, to be honest with you, because I don't use the VIX for a long time. I felt that the VIX was, you know, kind of a broken indicator. That doesn't make me right, doesn't make me wrong, right? It just makes me, right? But there are going to be other coaches who use it a lot. And so we can, of course, have those discussions. So if you can't find what you're looking for, don't hesitate to bring it up for discussion over in the lounge. We're more than happy to do that. And just because I don't want to talk VIX doesn't mean Coach Gino or Coach Tyler might not be really excited to talk about it. So hopefully that show you how you can find some of those, you know, whatever it is that you might be looking for. So hopefully that does help from that side of things. I know we're getting ready to wrap up here this evening, CR. Hopefully that helped, my friend. And if not, well, I wish I was more helpful, I guess. So that might be an easy way to find some things. And if, you know, if you can't really find it, you know, always feel free to drop us a line. We're always open to feedback and ideas and things like that. So nothing, you know, no shame in asking. What's the worst I can do? Tell you, I don't have a great answer for you. Let me see if I know somebody who does, right? I mean, there's no shame in asking. You know, the great thing about tackle trading, I personally believe, is that while no one here can make my trades for me any more than I can make your trades for you, we can help each other out in a variety of ways, right? If I have a chart set up that I think, you know, checks all the boxes, I'm more than happy to share it with you. And if you think that, Frank, that's ugly, okay, fair enough. You don't have to trade it, right? But what if you think it is nice and you want to put it in your watch list? Or, you know, what if you've got a, you know, a system that's really working for you on selling naked puts? And you know, hey, I'm open to hearing some ideas. So it's just a great way to be able to share, you know, ideas, bounce around, hang out with other traders. You all probably know this, for most of us traders, most of our neighbors, friends, sisters, brothers, husbands, wives, children, stuff like that, most of us don't know a lot of traders in, you know, quote unquote, real life, right? You know, trading is kind of one of those things that either you really like and you do, or you just don't really care, right? You know, and a lot of people in my, you know, normal life, when I talk to them about trading, they just kind of look at me like they want me to shut up. But I love talking about trading. And I love that I have a place that I can go to talk trading with people who speak my language, who are just as excited to talk about this stuff as me, and don't look at me like they want me to shut up and go away. So, you know, there's a great sense, in my opinion, you know, being around other traders, being able to pick their brains, share ideas with them, all of that stuff, I think is very powerful personally. And I'm glad that you've taken an opportunity to check that out. Of course, if you aren't already a pro member, there will be a link on the bottom of this video that will get you set up for a pro membership for a trial if you are interested. I know that Osiris, you said it was maybe acting up a little bit. So if it is, I'll bring that up to our tech team. Hopefully that's just a little hiccup if it's still doing that. You're always welcome to come over, check us out, hang out with us for a couple of weeks, see what we're all about. I use this to get some ideas. More than welcome. Love to have you. So that's always, that offer is always on the table. You're always welcome around us. Always welcome to hang out in our YouTube stuff, whether you're a pro member or not. We love having you around. I certainly invite you to join us on any of our social media channels. If you're using those platforms already, certainly invite you. If you're a Twitter user, I'll be extra excited, because that's where I live. so that's my social media platform of choice. But even if it's not yours, certainly extend that invitation to you to come join us on these different platforms. If there are no other questions this evening, I will let you get out of here tonight, but I do hope that this helped explain a little bit more about tackle trading, show you around a little bit, get a better idea of what we're about. And you're very welcome, Matt. Glad that it was helpful. It was my pleasure, my friend. And I'll be doing it again next Monday. You're always welcome to join me. Don't feel obligated by any means, but if it would be helpful, you're certainly welcome to join me to go through this process again. Of course, the video will be posted on the channel. As soon as our live stream's over, it will post if you need to revisit any or all of our discussion. one way or another, I'm pretty sure I'll see all of you again, whether it's on YouTube, in this webinar on Fridays, hanging out in the Halftime Report, over on Twitter, in the Clubhouse, in our other shows. I'm around a lot. I'm always happy to help you. The rest of the coaches, the rest of the community, we're all on the same page. You need something, let somebody know. Sometimes you need some help, and there's no shame in that. Just, ask, right? We've all had some questions, and we all probably will in the future. So never hesitate to reach out if you need a little help, whether it's to us on Twitter, in the Clubhouse, send us an email, asking our shows, heading to that lounge, whatever it might be. We're here for you. Don't hesitate if you need anything. With that, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. Appreciate your time here this evening. I'll let you get out of here. Have a wonderful rest of your Monday night. I'll see you all again very, very soon. Welcome to Tackle Trading. Thanks for coming and hanging out with me this evening. Have a great night. Stay warm out there, and I will see